स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 3, माई सेल्फ निकिता पटेल फ्रॉम सारस्वत इंटरनेशनल अकेडमी. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 2, फन विथ नंबर्स पार्ट 2. नाउ आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज धोनीज सेंचुरी. नाउ हियर व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सेंचुरी? सेंचुरी मीन्स टोटल 100. Now if you count in terms of time, or as you can say calendar, one century is equal to 100 years. Now what about century given in this page that we have to see? One day match between India and South Africa in Guwahati, India batting first. As we all know in cricket, what is century? Century means to make 100 runs. Now here they have asked us Dhoni on 96. Now Dhoni is on the 96. Only one ball is left. Will he complete his century? So he has totally made 96 runs already. And look at this, what a marvelous six. Now in the last ball left, he batted and scored 6. So here he completed his century, more than 100 runs. So here this lady is asking, has he completed his century? So how he completed his century? We have to fill in this blanks. Dhoni has already scored 96 runs, means already 96 runs were there, and then on the last ball he scored 6 runs. So 96 plus 6, if you add, you will get 102 runs, means more than 100. So more than a century. How many runs do these players need to complete a century? Like this, if Dhoni, he had in the last ball he hitted 6. So if we have to see, to complete the century we have to score how many runs are needed for all these players. So first player here is player 1. He has already scored 93 runs. So century means 100 runs. So he has to make 100. So out of 100, if we minus 93, how much we get? 7. So more 7 runs he need to score to complete a century. Player 2 here, 97 run he is already having runs. So 100 minus 97, if you do, you will get 3. So he needs 3 more runs to complete a century. Player 3, 89 runs. Already he had scored 89 runs. So now 100 minus 89, so 11 runs more he need to score. Now player 4 already 99 runs he has scored. So 100 minus 99, if we do, we get 1. So one more run player 4 need to score. So by this we learned about some bigger numbers, 3-digit number, that is 100. Now 100 is the first 3-digit number. Let us do the revision of previous things. From 1 to 9, it is 1-digit number. From 10 to 99, they are 2-digit number. And from 100, 3-digit number starts. So now we have to learn more 3-digit number, how to speak and how to read it out, the larger numbers. So on the next page, as you can see, after 99 we go on like this. So after 99 what comes? 100, 101, 102. So this is the next numbers which we have to read it out. Now fill in the blanks. Here they have given from 99 to 112 numbers, how to write in words and figures. So as you can see, in figures they have written here and in words they have written here. So some of them, as you can see, somewhere blanks are given, so we have to complete that blanks. Now 99, how do we write 99? NINETY, 90, NINE, 9. 100, how do we write 100? 100, 101. As you say, read the numbers, same way you have to write the number names, means in words. So 102, so the in words, how we will write? O-N-E-1, H-U-N-D-R-E-D, 100, E-W-O, 2. Then it is going on. 103 means 103, 104. Now it comes in words, it is already given 105. So we have to write in figure 105. 106, 106. 107 is given, but in words we have to write 107. 108, it is not given, it is given in words, so we have to write 108. 109, so write in words 109. 110, same way write in words. 111, then 112 is given in words, so we have to write in figures. Now we will go ahead with from 195 to 20, means 206. So how do we write and read this number in figures? 195, how we say this number? Same way we have to write in words. 195. 196 will be written as 196. 197 will be written as 197. 198 will be written as 198. Now 199 is written in words, but in figures we have to write 199. 200, so write down same way 200. 201, 201. Now here you can see in figures also it is not written and in words also it is not written. So we can write now easily 202 and 202. 203, 203. 204 is not written in figures, but it is written in words. So we can write 204. 205, same way 205. 206 is written in figures, so you can write in words 206. So here we completed what they have given us. We have completed the blanks. Now next, as you can see in this box, O206. Guess how many to make a triple century. Now for one century we need 100 runs. For 2 century we will need 200 runs, and for 3, means triple century, we will need 300 runs. So triple means, I have written here, see, 300. So if for triple it is 300 and we already have 206, so subtract 206 from 300, you will get 94. So 94 more you need to make a triple century. So students, here we completed our part 2 and hope all of you understood what we learned today. Practice this at home. Thank you, students.